The city of Bordeaux is located in southwest France within the department of the Gironde, named after the estuary which splits this wine region neatly in two. The two halves of the region are referenced as left bank and right bank of the estuary accordingly. Bordeaux's climate is moderated by the nearby Atlantic Ocean, which prolongs the growing season but can bring detrimental inclement weather during harvest. The region is most famous for blended red wines from Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, and Petit Verdot.
I'm standing in the Médoc. The Médoc is the northern part of the Bordeaux wine region's left bank, which stretches from just north of the city itself to just shy of Le Verdon-sur-Mer on Aquitaine's Atlantic coast. Traditionally, England has been the primary market for the wines of Bordeaux, particularly the reds, known as claret.
The wines have been regularly shipped from the region to London since the Duchy of Aquitaine belonged to the English House of Plantagenet between the 12th and 15th centuries. The shipped wines were mainly from Graves, a region to the south of Bordeaux, often blended with wines from outside the region.
It was the 17th century and the arrival of the Dutch that proved to be the Médoc's genesis as a wine region. Prior to this, the whole area was just marshland.
But Dutch engineers implemented a system of canals called jalles, which drained the water away into the Gironde estuary, exposing gravel mounds close to the river, which are today the source of some of the most prized wines in the world. The region is split into two larger appellations, Médoc AOP, or Appellation d'Origine Protégée, and Haut-Médoc AOP. The Médoc AOP is the largest appellation. It is for red wines only, and is generally used for the most difficult vineyards to ripen, north of the commune of Saint-Estèphe. The Haut-Médoc is a superior appellation for red wines dominated by Cabernet Sauvignon, and its boundaries contain six communes, four of which are considered the premier appellations of the Médoc. From north to south, these are Saint-Estèphe, Pauillac, Saint-Julien, and Margaux, home of the world-famous premier cru, Château Margaux. Premier Cru in Bordeaux does not form part of the appellation structure as it does in Chablis, but in this case refers to Château Margaux's status as a first growth in the famous 1855 classification of the Médoc Château. At the request of Napoleon III, Bordeaux's Chamber of Commerce were asked to select Bordeaux's top wines to present at the 1855 World Expo in Paris. They compiled a ranking based on price in the form of a league table with five divisions, first to fifth, or Premier Cru, first growth, to Cinquième Cru, fifth growth. With one or two exceptions, the classification remains unchanged to this day and includes some of the most sought-after names in the world of wine.
One chateau that is universally recognized as vastly overachieving compared to its third growth status is Chateau Palmer. The chateau is named after the handsome English general, Charles Palmer, who in the early 19th century bought the estate from a wealthy young widow that he met on a stagecoach. Even though, due to his extravagant lifestyle, he was forced to sell the estate, it still bears his name.
Chateau Palmer was classified in 1855 as a third growth. This is a piece of our history here in the Médoc. But then, of course, you know, more than 150 years helped to develop the estate. Today, Palmer is really considered to be one of the very best estates of the Médoc. And I think what makes Palmer so special is really the style of the wine, a unique style that comes from a unique place. This style is very easy to recognize. There are really two aspects of it. One is what you feel when you have the wine in your palate. We call it this velvety touch. This is a very special feeling that the tannins will give you. And the second aspect is the aromatic. All our wines are extremely aromatic, extremely complex. And so the combination of those two aspects makes our wine so special, and so the estate so special. So at Chateau Palmer, we have three grape varieties: Cabernet Sauvignon, of course, Merlot, and an old one called the Petit Verdot. Our percentage of Petit Verdot in our final blends is quite high, higher than most of our neighbors. This brings something very special. This brings something to the structure of the wine. The Petit Verdot we use most of the time between 5 and 8, 9% in the final blend is like the main beam of the roof, where everything, you know, is attached. In the 70s and in the 80s, the Petit Verdot was not used a lot. Because it's not an easy grape variety to grow. The Petit Verdot will produce quite a bit of fruit, and if you are not able to manage the yield, it will not ripe very easily. So what we did here in the 90s and the 2000s was really to readapt the farming of this grape variety, and we saw the quality boom going up, and that's why we used that much. And I have the feeling that we will see this Petit Verdot going up in most of the blends because also of the global warming, you know. The Petit Verdot has a great ability to resist to heat. So in biodynamic, you have a lot of different tools. You know, it's a general view, but we also have tools. One that is quite famous is a very strange preparation called the 500. It's just manure that you would put in a horn that you would bury for 8 months. And then you would use this preparation that smells very good, doesn't smell manure at all. After this process, you would use like 150 grams more or less per hectare, having you know, using it in water. You dynamize the water and you spray on the soil. What it brings to the soil is really energy and power, and we really have checked that scientifically, and we have seen that with this preparation, the quantity of microorganism in the soil has really increased. So that's a very good example of a specific biodynamic preparation. The moon has its importance. You know, we all know what is the impact of the moon on the ocean, you know. There is impact of the moon on a lot of process. For example, there are certain periods of time where we don't prune in winter because this is not a good phase with the moon. We call it in French nœud lunaire, a moon nod, I suppose, in English. And we have experimented and we've seen that it doesn't work.
Over on the right bank of the Gironde, Merlot is the dominant grape variety, supported by Cabernet Franc and in some cases, Cabernet Sauvignon as well. The town of Le Bon is neighbour to the two most famous appellations of the right bank, Pomerol and Saint-Emilion.
Vine cultivation and winemaking in Saint-Emilion can trace their history back to the Roman thirst for wine in the 4th century, but it wasn't until the 8th century arrival of a Benedictine monk called Emilion that Saint-Emilion was officially founded.
The limestone slope and plateau encompassing this picturesque hilltop village and reaching out towards the tiny village of Saint-Hippolyte form the bedrock of the vineyards here. This limestone is overlaid by cool clay soils that are particularly suitable for the Merlot vine and play host to the majority of Premier Grand Cru Classé, around 15 minutes to the northwest, bordering the much smaller but equally prestigious appellation of Pomerol, is a gravel terrace that is home to the remainder and is especially suited to Cabernet Franc.
The classification of the wines of Saint-Emilion differs from the one across the Gironde. There are two appellations in Saint-Emilion, Saint-Emilion AOP and Saint-Emilion Grand Cru AOP. Both cover the same 5,500 hectare area, but the Grand Cru wines require stricter protocols, including a higher minimum alcohol level, which, as you would expect, naturally privileges the sites with the more sun-exposed aspect.
The Grand Cru AOP currently contains in excess of 200 chateaux, 64 of which are denoted as Grand Cru Classé, and 18 deemed Premier Grand Cru Classé.
Unlike in the Médoc, the classification here is revised every 10 to 12 years or so, with some chateaux awarded promotion and some unceremoniously demoted, either from one tier to another or out of the classification completely, often kicking and screaming.
Just to keep things interesting, the 18 Premier Grand Cru chateaux are further subdivided into two more quality tiers. 14 are considered Premier Grand Cru Classé B, and just 4 are Premier Grand Cru Classé A.
Our next stop is at the most prestigious of these, in the heart of Saint-Emilion's gravel terrace, Château Cheval Blanc.
So Cheval Blanc is a very special growth in the world of the right bank because we are in the middle between the Pomerol Plateau and the Saint-Emilion Plateau. Cheval Blanc is quite unique because we have 39 hectares close to Pomerol with 11 different types of soil. What makes Cheval Blanc very special is the huge diversity of soil we have. We have some clay soil, some gravelly soil, some sandy soil. So that huge diversity builds the complexity of our wines. This is one of the first reasons why Cheval Blanc is so special. But in other hand, Cheval Blanc is special too because of the huge percentage of Cabernet Franc we have in the vineyard. So you know that the right bank of Bordeaux is well known through the Merlot variety. Cheval Blanc with more than 60% of Cabernet Franc is unique in the world of all Bordeaux and specifically the right bank. The way we manage our vineyard as well is very special because on the 39 hectares of Cheval Blanc, we manage 53 different plots that we consider as 53 mini vineyards, independent, autonomous. And each plot is going to bring something special to the blend of Château Cheval Blanc. So it's a plot per plot management of the vineyard. Because we built a new winery 8 years ago, we have now the capacity to vinify each plot separately in different type of vats, so we can work more precisely with that plot selection. So Cheval Blanc have a lot of Cabernet Franc, which is an exceptional grape variety, of course. We can explain the typicity of Cabernet Franc through a certain freshness, delicacy, complexity, elegance. But Cabernet Franc is very difficult to manage because this wine can be exceptional or very bad. You have nothing in the middle. So the exigence of the soil should be very dry to produce some very small berries with a very nice concentration. So in the book, you can read that Cabernet match very well with the gravel. That's true, but not the only soil that is good for the Cabernet Franc. In Cheval Blanc, we have the Cabernet Franc on all the different type of soil because we want to bring a certain complexity, a certain diversity through the blending. So as well, Cabernet Franc match very, very well with clay soil, but you should have very, very precise viticulture to obtain a very nice concentration and to preserve the freshness, the flower aroma, the red berry aroma, which is a sign of great Cabernet Franc in the world. After the picking, we start to produce the wine. And as well, concerning the Cabernet Franc, we should be very careful with this grape variety, which is very fragile and very delicate. So we try to work enough in the vineyard to have a nice concentration, but we don't believe in the extraction in the cellar. The density, the powerful of a wine come from the terroir, come from the vineyard, not from the recipe in the cellar. So we are very gentle, the maceration are very, very slow, but very long. We need around 25 to 30 days of maceration, but just few pumping over to extract very, very gently. And after, we start the aging process. So in French, we have a beautiful word to explain what happened in the aging cellar, which is élevage. Élevage means rising. This is a notion of education. We educate our wine during the aging because we're going to find a better balance. We're going to try to integrate all the elements of the wine together to have a nice expression, a nice coherence, a delicacy that is going to help everybody to enjoy our wines.
Bordeaux's winemaking history is replete with an ever-growing catalogue of dynasties that play host every April to wine merchants from across the globe. They are here to place futures or imprimeur orders for the latest vintage while it still lies maturing in cask. Perhaps the best place of all members of the Bordeaux clans to describe the market the wines are sold on, the Place de Bordeaux, is Pierre Lurton, president not only of Château Cheval Blanc, but also president of one of the world's most prestigious sweet wine producers, Château d'Yquem.
Is the Place de Bordeaux enters the niche market around the world. Is the distribution of the niche, and in general you have 20 and 40 and 50 different negotiants, and the negotiants have a specialty in USA, more specialty in Asia. When you pick the grapes, you finish your vinification, and for example, 2019. Now the vintage is very quiet in the barrels, but in April in 2020, a lot of people came here for the future, a lot of people and the journalists and the importateurs, etc., arrive here to test the wine, to have the impression of the wine. I think it's a very amazing moment because all the planet know the quality of the wine. And after, I put the wine in the market, in the Bordeaux market. And I distribute the wine at the different negotiants. But the journalist put the rating. Don't you have the influencer put the note. And after, the wine is distributed during 1 month, 2 months, around the world. For example, Emirates use this system of Place de Bordeaux. Why Emirates use? Because you have the direct contact with the cellar. It's an ex-chateau wine. Donc, it's very important to have the direct contact because you control your wine, you control the quality. But also, Emirates came during the future to test the wine directly. I have the direct contact with Emirates. And for Emirates, you have the guarantee of the quality. You have the guarantee to have the way of this bottle is the direct between the cave and Emirates. I think it's the best, because if you brought the bottle at the different place around the world, we are not sure for the quality of the wine, for the conservation, and for the origin also. Donc, the Place de Bordeaux give to Emirates, and for me, the direct contact is, and you are sure for the quality of the wine.
Emirates included Chateau Cheval Blanc 2004 in the inaugural selection for the Emirates Vintage Collection, a range of wines that Emirates pick out every year to represent the creme de la creme of the bottles from its extensive cellar. The launch of the collection was celebrated with a tasting in the A380 onboard lounge, where Cheval Blanc could be sampled by passengers in first and business class. Wines from the Emirates Vintage Collection are highlighted on your wine list by a special icon, as are organic wines, exclusive wines, and wines that are available for purchase at Le Clos Luxury Wines and Spirits Boutiques in Dubai International Airport. We change from wine to spirits for our next episode as we explore the world-famous region of Cognac. Join us on the Emirates Wine Channel.